Discuss the kinetics of hydrolysis of ethyl acetate. Ethyl acetate is a colorless liquid with sweet smell. Ethyl acetate is used as a solvent and diluent. Ethyl acetate on hydrolysis produces acetic acid and ethyl alcohol. This reaction is catalyzed by any dilute acid, for example sulfuric acid or hydrochloric acid. In this reaction, as seen from the equation, acetic acid is formed. So, the rate of reaction can be measured by measuring the concentration of acid formed at different time intervals. To find the concentration of acetic acid, we take small amount of reaction mixture and titrate it against sodium hydroxide or any base. But in this case, there is a small problem that the reaction mixture contains acetic acid and also sulfuric acid. So, the equivalence point of the titration is for both the acids. Let me write the equation again. So, ethyl acetate plus water plus sulfuric acid produces acetic acid plus ethyl alcohol. At the start of reaction, when time is equals to 0, amount of acetic acid will be 0. So, the volume of sodium hydroxide for equivalence point is only because of sulfuric acid present in the reaction mixture. Therefore, we can write volume of sodium hydroxide at 0 time, V0, is proportional to amount of sulfuric acid. This is equation number 1. Let's assume after time t, the volume of sodium hydroxide for equivalence point is Vt. At this time, as the reaction is started, reaction mixture will have both sulfuric acid and acetic acid. Therefore, volume of sodium hydroxide at time t, which is Vt, will be proportional to amount of sulfuric acid plus amount of acetic acid. This is equation number 2. Now, subtracting equation 1 from equation 2, we get Vt minus V0 is proportional to amount of acetic acid, as amount of sulfuric acid gets cancelled. Both amount of acetic acid produced depend on amount of ethyl acetate reacted at that time, which is X. So, above equation can be written as Vt minus V0 is proportional to X. At infinite time, all the reactant, all ethyl acetate is reacted and is converted into acetic acid. Therefore, at this time, the amount of acetic acid formed is dependent on total quantity of ethyl acetate taken initially, which is A. Therefore, we can write volume of sodium hydroxide at infinite time, V infinite, is proportional to amount of sulfuric acid plus initial amount of ethyl acetate. This is equation number 4. Subtracting equation 1 from equation number 4. So, V infinite minus V0 is proportional to initial concentration of ethyl acetate. Or we can say V infinite minus V0 is proportional to A. This is equation number 5. Now, we got the value of A from equation number 5 and value of X from equation 3. Let's substitute these values in first order rate equation. That is, K is equals to 2.303 divided by T log of A by A minus X. We get K is equals to 2.303 divided by T log of V infinite minus V0 divided by V infinite minus V0 minus Vt minus V0. Let's open the bracket. So, K becomes 2.303 divided by T log of V infinite minus V0 divided by V infinite minus V0 minus Vt plus V0. Here, V0 gets cancelled. So, K becomes 2.303 divided by T log of V infinite minus V0 divided by V infinite minus Vt. Thus, hydrolysis of ethyl acetate can be tested with this equation, and it was proved that the reaction is of first order. Let's try to solve a numerical based on this equation. 1 ml of ethyl acetate was added to 25 ml of 2 normal hydrochloric acid. 2 ml of the mixture were withdrawn from time to time during the progress of the hydrolysis of the ester and titrated against standard sodium hydroxide solution. The amount of sodium hydroxide required for titration at various intervals is given as time in minutes, 0, 20, 75, 119, 183 and infinite, while sodium hydroxide used is 20.24, 21.73, 25.20, 27.60, 30.22, 43.95. The value at infinite time was obtained by completing the hydrolysis on boiling. Show that it is a reaction of the first order and find the average value of the velocity constant. In this case, V0 is 20.24 ml and V infinite is 43.95 ml. So, let's calculate rate constant at each time interval using first order equation, which is K is equals to 2.303 divided by T log of A by A minus X, or in this case K is equals to 2.303 divided by T log of V infinite minus V0 divided by V infinite minus VT. At time T is equals to 20 minutes, volume of sodium hydroxide used is 21.73 ml. So let's put the values. K becomes 2.303 divided by 20 log of 43.95 minus 20.24 divided by 43.95 minus 21.73. This becomes 0.115 into log of 23.71 divided by 22.22, which is 0.115 into log of 1.067, and finally 0.00324 minute inverse. At time t is equals to 75 minute, volume of sodium hydroxide used is 25.20 ml. So K becomes 2.303 divided by 75 log of 23.71. I have directly taken the difference, divided by 43.95 minus 25.20, which is 0.0307 into log of 23.71 divided by 18.75, which is 0.0307 into log of 1.267, and finally it gives 0.00313 minute inverse. Let's calculate for time t is equals to 119 minute, where the volume of sodium hydroxide is 27.6 ml. So K becomes 2.303 divided by 119 log of 23.71 divided by 43.95 minus 27.60, which is 0.0194 into log of 23.71 divided by 16.35, which is 0.0194 into log of 1.450. This comes 0.00313 minute inverse. And lastly, at time t is equals to 183 minute, volume of sodium hydroxide is 30.22 ml. So K becomes 2.303 divided by 183 log of 23.71 divided by 43.95 minus 30.22, which is 0.0126 into log of 23.71 divided by 13.73. which comes 0.0126 into log of 1.727, which gives 0.00299 minute inverse. Since the value of K, rate constant, is nearly constant, therefore given reaction is of first order, and the average value for the rate constant is 0.00312 minute inverse. If you like this video, please click on the like button and also subscribe to my channel. If you have any doubt, you can write in comment box and also share with your friends.